Hello everybody, this is Marielle, and yes, Yepsy Star, everybody knows me from YouTube, anyway, but today I want to show you what we have to do when a short-nosed dog is getting an inverting sneezing or a tracheal collapse episode, because this sometimes can happen with especially short-nosed breeds like the Shih Tzu, but also like pugs and sometimes even larger dogs like boxers. And my Jessie, who passed over in 2011, her breeder had a lovely method which I also use, because my Jimmy is an inverter sneezer, and my Jessie was, and my Muppy was, and so probably my Riley might be, but she is still a puppy, so she hasn't shown yet, but it can occur with her too. Well, our example dog of today is my crystal dog, Elmo. And not that he is an inverted sneezer, but it is easy to show for beginners with a longer-nosed dog how it works, actually. And so I will show you with Elmo how things work out, because this is a great method. If you know how it works, it is very great, and it always helps too. Okay, let's go. Okay, here we got my Elmo. He has a long nose, so he is not an inverted sneezer. But normally, if a dog makes these strange noises and he is an inverted sneezer, he or she will stay like this and will be quite panicked too, because not knowing what's happening. Then what I used to do is not taking up, but just patting and just making your dog calm by patting it. And if he or she still makes those noises, then I usually, well, with small dogs, with larger dogs you have to stand, but usually with smaller dogs I will sit down like this, and I will put the back part of the dog between my legs, because then he or she can't go. Thank you, Elmo. Elmo is licking me. The next step I do is this. And then I'll be sure that the tracheal pipe is in one line. What I do next is put open its beak, the mouth open, like this. And then Elmo doesn't like it, but then, because the mouth is open, your dog is forced to breathe in a natural way, because if the mouth is too long open, your dog will also swallow because of the things going backwards. And I keep it open like this with two hands, and most of the times your dog will get relaxed. And then I will keep my finger and I will try to ease my dog like this. And if your dog is eased and it's the breathing is getting more regular after 2 minutes mostly, but luckily after 5 minutes I stop the procedure, but I keep it going like this sometimes for 10 minutes, yeah, as long as it needs. And then if it stops, it's okay. And if your dog is breathing normally, you just can keep petting it, and most likely is that your dog will get thirsty because of this and walks away to the water bowl to have some drink.
Thank you, Elmo.
Yeah, thank you. Well, Elmo.
Good, good job. I fed my dog because he did a wonderful job. And he is not an inverting sneezer, so he actually
But well, the most important thing with this method is that while you do this, you talk in an easily way to your dog. You know, saying it's okay, it's all right, and things will come all right. You know, like that words, and that is brave. And if you do that while you're doing this method, maybe the first time will be a problem because your dog totally doesn't know what's happening. Like your dog totally won't know. Sorry for my English. Won't know what's happening with this inverting sneezing episode at all the first time. So the first time, if you use this method, probably you will get some resistance, but then after you use it for a couple of times, third time or so with the with another episode, then you soon will notice your dog will know what you're doing and that it will help him ease and that it will bring back to normal breathing. So, well, it needs a bit of practice and it needs a bit of exercise, but actually all dogs, even Shih Tzu, but actually all dogs dealing with this problem are smart enough to learn what this is for. So, well, maybe the first couple of times will be a bit of a problem, but after that your dog soon will know that it will help, and that's it is a helpful thing to know and to do. So just keep his mouth open as long as this weird breathing occurs, and if you notice that this beforehand part of your dog is getting more relaxed, less trembling, and that the breathing starts to get normal again, and when it's totally normal, you just can let your dog go again. But until then, you have to use this method. And my experience is also that it also forecomes another episode. So how more you use this method while your dog is having an episode, if you use the method another time when your dog is having an episode, the episodes will start to be shorter and less intense, and they even will occur lesser in a year. So it's really helpful. It is really a helpful method. Okay, I hope you will have another good part of information, and just feel free to ask any questions if you have any according to this. I really would like to help you, because it helped my dogs a lot, it helped Jesse a lot, it helped Mappy a lot. And Jimmy is happily after all, not a real bad inverting sneezer. Maybe he has one till twice an episode a year, so, well, and we will see with Riley. But my little Elmo, happily after all, doesn't need any of this method. Huh? No. But thanks a lot for showing us. Yeah? Yeah. Bye.